think part of it is accepting that it's so much beauty in being Black. And that's the thing that I guess I get emotional about, because I've always known that. I've always been proud to be Black. Never wanted to be nothing else. Loved everything about it. Just, it's such beauty in Black people.
If you don't understand us and understand what we've been through, then you probably wouldn't understand what this moment is about. This is home. This is where we're from. This is where we belong.
My hair is my power and my strength.
You robbing and stealing from the people that been there for so many years, not just coming.
So this is my strength, my power. You know, I just love it.
Being on the camera, both in photography and video, is what helped me see the beauty in my natural hair. Last summer, I took a pre-college class doing film and photography at FIT. And at first, being on the camera was a little nerve-wracking, but when I finally saw the final projects, I was amazed. Many times, the people behind the camera capture the beauty in my hair before I even recognized it for myself. And so I feel like photography is a really powerful tool within the natural hair movement, because it gives pride to people who have had to learn how to love their hair. So growing up, I always felt a hint of shame toward my hair because it was never as curly or long as my sister's. For me, Stero Styles is all about combating the negativity that natural hair has faced in our society. The standard of beauty has always set straight hair as superior to the natural hair. And even within the natural hair community, looser curl patterns are seen as more beautiful than kinky, coily, or coarse hair. This beauty standard has affected generations who were taught to ultimately change their hair in order to love it.
This like sophomore year in high school, I felt so uncomfortable with my curls because I didn't know what to do with them. Like, I was like, they're just there on my head. So I used to straighten it like every week, and it was possibly the worst thing I've ever done for my hair.
I really relate, because like in middle school, I feel like you just kind of get pressured, especially like when you're going through puberty, to like be like everybody else. So I would like straighten my hair like weekly, and it was so damaged and stuff, but like I didn't care because it was straight. But then like sophomore year, I like chopped it all off because I was like, nah, like it's just not, like it's not the move. Like I don't want to be like everybody else because like I'm not like everybody else.
I can relate to them just because my curl pattern is very different. It's like wavy in the back, curly, more curly in the front. So I thought, okay, how about just have like one pattern? So I straightened my hair so many times in middle school and high school.
How does your natural hair make you feel?
Amazing. Yeah, literally. Like I love my curls. Yeah. Like the natural like hair movement, I think it's a blessing. Yeah. Like there's so many things I can do with my hair. Like even though I'm not pressured to straighten my hair, I can do it, but I can still have curls. I think curly hair is the best.
And it's nice to like have like people around you now that like look like you, and you're not like the outlier anymore. Cause like I feel like when we were all younger, it was like, okay, like Barbie doll has straight hair. Like it was like dark or like brown or whatever, but she has straight hair, and it was just like that factor that we couldn't have. So now it's just like, okay, now you have like Barbie doll with curly hair. So like I wish we were like little kids now, so that we didn't like have to like I guess go through like what we did, because like it's so empowering now, like to just like be like a person of color and like have everyone around you accept themselves instead of like always wanting to be like someone else.
And so what do you think really helped you find pride in your natural hair?
I guess social media.
Yeah.
So many Instagram models and also YouTubers that do all these hair videos that, you know, not really like we've seen in middle school, but now that more people are like, our generation is like more grown up when we're accepting like who we are and our flaws.
My hair is definitely a part of me. I would not be who I am if it wasn't this, like, for my hair. I remember as a kid, my hair is down to my butt and it was curly. Like, I was a straight up Hispanic Rapunzel. Like,
I can relate to that.
My hair, like, I love it absolutely. Like, it is a part of me.
Like each different hairstyle that you do, like natural hair, it's like a whole different
style. Yeah.
You straighten your hair, it's like Hillary Clinton. And then it's like, if you wear your afro, it's just like, yeah, I'm can do like braids and buns and stuff like that. Like you're like a different girl like every week, and I love that so much. I feel like if I was bald or like I didn't hair, like I just
not really be much you can do. You literally can't do anything in your bald.
So what makes Stero Styles by Lorna Simpson so captivating is that it shows an honest depiction of natural hair, not natural hair conforming to the standard of beauty that straight hair is best, but it's showing it in its natural form. It captures natural hair in an honest depiction, and it empowers women by describing it in positive words rather than bashing natural hair and giving it the negative label that our society has described it to be for years. Photography is the way that I express my love and appreciation for my natural hair, whether it's just in a twist out or straight or in braids. My hair is something that I take pride in.